And welcome to AMR TV Australia and The Morgue Presents. And this is Chris Coroner next to me, and I'm Gareth McDowell. And we're going to be bringing you some pretty special videos over the next, few episodes, however many we get in, I suppose, Chris.
Yeah, let's go for 100 episodes.
Yeah, 100 sounds good to me. And welcome to the show, man.
Thank you.
And this is all filmed at AMR.fm Studio, Melbourne, and hopefully going all around the world. So we're going to be bringing you some... I'm going to have a bit of a mixed bag, mostly some heavy rock, and rock from around the scene, from the alternative scene here in Australia, and as well as some other bits and pieces, even some hip hop here and there as well. So, pretty much bits and pieces. That's all I can say. Chris, what are you going to be doing?
I'll be doing metal. That's it, pretty much. No mixed bag here. It's just all heavy metal, and going to have some brutal clips on the show. Tonight we have Anion, Harlot, and Before Ciara.
Alrighty, and I've got six videos coming up. We've got Drawn from Bees, Fitzy. We've got an interview with Without Parachutes, which was awesome fun. So that's coming up very shortly. We're going to play a bit of Overreactor with Ezekiel Ox, and some Blind Monkey and Hail Mary. So hang around. Hope you enjoy the show. And this is it, Chris. Episode number one. So
episode one.
Hope you guys enjoy it. AMR TV and The Morgue Presents.
Yep.
Enjoy. We'll be back shortly. Here's the first clip. It's Drawn from Bees. It's a Brisbane band, and it's called Calling You Out. Enjoy.
Through this glass I cannot see. My distraction comes from me. Left alone I won't survive. But it comes as some surprise. I would choose to close my eyes. Calling you out, calling you out, calling you out from a world of sadness. Calling you out, calling you out, calling you out from a place of pain. Taking you out, taking you out, taking you out. See things I should not see.
and welcome back to AMR TV Australia. And that was Drawn from Bees calling you out. Next up, we've got Fitzy. And for those of you that don't know Fitzy, he's on the Australian Musicians Radio show called The Hour of Power. You can catch him here and there. We've got a few shows coming up shortly, and he's going to have some pretty special guests in as well. So catch Fitzy on The Hour of Power. And a little bit about Fitzy. He's from Echuca, or around the Bendigo and Echuca area. He spent 6 years in the Navy, and he's come back to do the hip-hop thing. So here he is, Fitzy with Golden Rule. Enjoy.
Hey, what's up, man? Yeah, the show's tonight. I'll be down there soon. I just got something to take care of first. Alright, see ya.
Ain't no shit, I'ma rock this year. Got my mic and my mind ain't soft this year. I'ma get up and rip up the spot this year. Hate to sit back and just suck a cock this year. It's the underground season, the vibe is easier. Kill a fucking beat, thank you kindly, Creed. And I feel like I'm be what I finally need. So I rep my beeps every time I breathe. The respect I'm getting is building up. So I'ma go home for real this summer. I'ma unroll my swag on the banks of the Murray and drink with my brothers until I'm I feel so glad that I went and done it. I went around the world to defend my country. Now it's back to the bush with a lesson, huh? See, when you're actually pushed, you can step it up. These days the world's moving quickly. I keep my head down, y'all moving swiftly. Ain't no more sure, now I'm known as Fitzy. It's like I'm important, I got ownership. See, I'd like to give more, but I'm broke as shit. So I push with the force, I'll get over it. And I guess what I learned as my golden rule is that you can't ever stop, gotta show damn fools. I've been gone 6 years, I found myself. Got to see sick shit, I found it helps. And I lost old mates over time and that. But I ain't gonna hate, yo, I'm finally back. And I find with my rhymes I can finally smash. So I smile all the time, yo, it's finally happened. Used to write at high when I was back in maths. FB, she can vouch, as a matter of fact. Never once did she doubt I could actually rap. And well, yeah, now I can actually rap. New city that connects, new fam and friends. All the mates in the state, OCs and the rest. 2013 will be the year that redefines me. I heard it'll be the year the media find me. See, I work to be it, so ain't leaving lightly. And I lost my bro, so I'm finna fight, see? These days the world's moving quickly. I keep my head down, y'all moving swiftly. Ain't no more sure, now I'm known as Fitzy. It's like I'm important, I got ownership. See, I'd like to get more, but I'm broke as shit. So I push with the force, I'll get over it. And I guess what I learned as my golden rule is that you can't ever stop, gotta show damn fools. Why would I stop when they're listening now? You really think I'd change to fit in as well? Well, you were wrong from the dot, man. This is myself, I take pride in the following everyone else. It's all me. Yeah, you ain't seeing me switch out. The only thing different, you're witnessing this now. And we got them jizzing to witness the kick. Wow, hit the big city with the vision to rip down. Then done it, ironic, life isn't a mish now. Fuck it, I'm up and I'm wishing to get down. Give me one wish and I'm wishing it pans out. It's all said and done, still ain't got a regret. Now they come hit me up like they wanna reflect. Can I remember? Nah, well honest I can. Man, I'm raw to the core, I don't wanna pretend. Cause this moment right here, we ain't got it again. These days the world's moving quickly. I keep my head down, y'all moving swiftly. Ain't no more sure, now I'm known as Fitzy. It's like I'm important, I got ownership. See, I'd like to get more, but I'm broke as shit. So I push with the force, I'll get over it. And I guess what I learned as my golden rule is that you can't ever stop, gotta show damn fools.
And welcome back. And as I mentioned before, we're going to have some very special guests into the studio. And these guys have come in all the way from Wollongong. And I'm pretty pleased to have you guys here because we've been watching you guys pretty closely over the last couple of months. And pretty impressed, yeah. Welcome to the studio.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for having us. Yeah.
And this is without Parachutes, by the way, if you've never heard of them. And you guys have got a brand new video and a brand new single out at the moment. Who wants to talk about that first?
Oh, give it to Cooper.
Oh, yeah.
Just introduce yourselves too, if you can.
Oh, yeah. I'm Cooper, the sexy one.
I'm Will, not the sexy one.
I'm Bob, I'm the tall one.
Bob actually I recognise from the video. For When We Fall. And man, what would you have done if you had have actually caught up with the dudes?
I probably would just would have. Well, they were just actors. It wasn't real.
Oh, was it? Damn it!
Really? Quite a nice guy. Yeah.
Yeah? they could have at least given the bottle back.
Yeah. Well, he was a security guard.
I didn't actually notice you there. Yeah.
Oh, that's right. That's I played the part well. Method acting. I worked on it for about 3 or 4 months. Became security guard at a local RSL. So it's probably why he didn't recognise me. You know.
Just in character so well that he just morphed into the background.
Exactly. No. It's the whole film clip's based around like lockouts and stuff in Sydney. So obviously you guys don't have those sort of laws down here in Melbourne, but it's pretty shit in Sydney. So at the moment, it's pretty much killed the live music scene. Oh, it hasn't killed the live music scene, but it's really affecting it. So the whole film clip's a bit of a statement against that, really.
Okay.
But we're happy the way it came out. It's a pretty awesome film clip.
Where was it filmed?
It was filmed on Oxford Street in the CBD of Sydney.
Yep.
So that's the sort of where some of the violence has been happening. The company that made it was Paper Moose, that is like called Paper Moose Productions, and they just pretty much came to us with everything, the treatment, and we just went, yep, let's do that. And they just ran ahead and organised it all, and we just turned up on the night and they just told us where to stand and wave our arms around, and that's what we did. And we had no fucking idea what was happening. Hey, it was just like, yeah, all right. Oh, well, we think this looks, yeah. Exactly, man. It was fucking crazy, but no, it was cool. Came out. We were happy with how it turned out.
Was in it as well as a jealous boyfriend.
Yeah.
Also another method acting. So, yeah. Not normally a jealous boyfriend, but adopted that role for again another 3-4 months. You know, stopped my girlfriend from seeing friends, family, you know, just kept her at home, really.
Real life stuff.
Ball and chain,
yeah.
We are the least aggressive people in the world, too.
So awful. It was really
like,
ironic.
Be angry, and we're like, we're not angry people.
It was really ironic for us to be the angry people in a film clip. That was fun. It was fun for us.
Yeah, that's absolutely brilliant film clip, and congratulations, guys. And really hope it does well for you. So we're trying to spread the love in the US, and I actually sent it to the boss in Utah, and he couldn't believe you guys when it signed. So, I'm sure you'll get there one day.
Edit. You can edit that out.
And who wrote the song? What the songwriting processes and all that kind of thing?
The old golden boy behind me. Look at him and all his pride. His swagger. His delicious face. You just kind of want to lick him, hey?
Don't lick my face.
But yeah, no, Will's the main songwriter and the singer and the beauty of the band. And he also has the best boobies as well. So he gets them out often on stage. And yeah, it's good. We've got a good system happening, you know, and he sometimes gets his little bum out, does a bit of a shake as well, and you know, and we just get the fans in like that, and me and Robbie just sort of stand up the back in the shadows and just try and hide our hideous features. And that's, you know, that's just generally how it works. You know, and if we come out of the shadows, Will gets his little whip out, and he gives us a good whip, and we cower back, and I'll give the microphone back to you.
I'll save you here and ask you about your new album. When's that out? Is that too soon, or?
It's a bit too soon to actually say when it's out. We're still in the process of finishing recording and mixing up in Byron.
Yep.
Obviously, it's a fair distance from where we are, so we we save up and we head up for a few days at a time and spend some good time with Nick. So yeah, we're really loving up there. But probably maybe halfway through finishing the album, so it's still got a ways to go. Yeah. Hoping to get it up for the end of the year, but we'll just have to see how we go.
Okay.
Yeah.
And your new single, No Time to Lose, how have you been received with that?
So far it's been received really, really well. We've been sort of similar to when the film clip came out, we've just been inundated with messages of just
and support.
Lots of support and just people saying, you know, we think you're onto a good thing, and it's really encouraging for us.
Excuse me, I'm just choking.
Just a little bit
more of your eyes now.
A little bit of death helps you, you know, enjoy life.
Yeah,
it's all good.
Age prop.
Legend. So that's why we hired him. He's going to be a barman.
Not just a pretty face.
Not just a pretty face.
He's going to be the barman.
Hey fellas, where'd the idea come for the video?
The idea for the video was based on. Basically just on it was done by Paper Moose and Zay, I can never say Zayd's last name properly.
Ellicity.
Zayd Ellicity and the crew at Paper Moose put that all together for us, so yeah.
They gave us a few formulas and we went with the lockout one because it felt suitable to the song as well because we can incorporate it well with the lyrics.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Alrighty, and what else have we got? You got any further gigs coming up? It probably won't go to air until Wednesday or something. So
yeah.
Maybe the next month or so. You got anything coming up?
I think it's the 19th of this month, so 19th of June. I think it's a Thursday. If it's not the 19th of June, it's the Thursday that falls around the 19th of June. Yep. So whatever that is. Well, we're playing at the Captain Cook Hotel with a really cool band called Bright Young Things. They're sort of similar sound to us, very synth-based, but rock sort of. And yeah, they're pretty cool. So that's at the Captain Cook Hotel in Sydney, and that's free, which is awesome. And then we're actually supporting Voyager from Perth.
Oh.
Yeah, so that's happening at the Factory Bar in Marrickville on the 5th of July. So obviously they're getting a bit of exposure and stuff from what's his name? From from the Aussie Alternative.
From
Rod. Yeah, from Rod. Yeah, yeah. So Rod's giving them a bit of exposure and stuff, so hopefully that sort of goes pretty well. So they're the next two shows I got booked, and then hopefully we're looking to do another tour around end of August, start of September. We've applied to do Big Sound up in Brisbane, so if we could get into that, it'd be sick, and hopefully sort of try and orientate a tour around that. And yeah, so that's the plans from here. So on. Maybe we have another single release before then too, so we have something to, a bit more show.
Yep.
Yeah.
And you're touring anywhere else around the country coming up?
No, at the moment just East Coast. We just can't afford to do West Coast or Adelaide or anything yet, unfortunately. Maybe, hopefully next year we can sort of, by then we'll have enough exposure and enough fan base that we can sort of, some sponsors, yeah.
Yeah, we'll get you into Salt Lake City, man.
Fire
LA, that'd be good, what else have we got? Who plays what anyway? The instruments, just let everyone know what you're play and everything,
Well, I'm the drummer and I control the samples.
Yeah. I'm the guitarist and singer.
And I play bass.
Slap
on the bass.
Alrighty, cool. So there you go, people. That's Without Parachutes. And if you haven't caught them live, make sure you get out and catch them. And your music, where can we find your music?
We are social media whores. We are on everything. On Facebook we have links to our Bandcamp and SoundCloud. We have Spotify, iTunes. I think our original EP that we recorded ourselves is up there for free, so there's four songs there you can just have, and then there's the two latest singles, which I think are $1 each off Bandcamp.
And AMR.
And sorry, of course. And then, of course, we have like Unearthed and all that sort of bullshit as well. So it's all there.
And I've got to high five every one of you for getting on board, man.
Thank you for supporting us, man. That's awesome.
Yeah. Thanks for coming into the studio. And yeah, catch these guys wherever you can. Show them some love. Hit them up on Facebook, on AMR.FM. And yeah, without parachutes, thank you very much for coming into AMR.FM Studio Melbourne. And we'll catch you all guys, yeah, hopefully soon. Might come and catch you tomorrow night at, yeah, in Collingwood. Alrighty. We'll be back soon. Here is Without Parachutes with their brand new video, When We Fall. Welcome back, and that was Without Parachutes interview, and that was great fun catching up with those guys. Hope they can come back sometime, and yeah, if they're around town in your part of the world, wherever you are, catch them because they're an awesome band, and yeah, great bunch of folks, and yeah, Crispy on the camera met them as well, man, and we all had a bit of fun as well. Next up is we're going to hear Overreactor. This is called Mouth of the Ghetto. This is Ezekiel Ox, one of his projects. Overreacted, I don't really play anymore. But I saw those guys play live at the Creep Show in 2012, and it was a bit of a surprise show, I can guarantee you that. It just blew me away. So here is Overreactor with Mouth of the Ghetto. Welcome back to AMR TV Australia. That was Ezekiel Ox. Well, it was Ezekiel Ox's project called Overreactor, which I had the pleasure of seeing a couple of years ago at the SP Hotel. It was called the Creep Show in 2012. Absolutely awesome show. It was actually a show I wasn't expecting to see. I was there only to see one band and end up seeing Overreacted just before 10,000, and I tell you, this guy blew me away. So if you ever get to see Ezekiel Ox, as he's known now, get out and see him. Blind Monkey was he's going to come up next after him with Deaf System, and we'll be back after that.
insisting cares seems to resist the urge to share with the disposable ones who are soon to become byproducts of your disposable income. Pulling on the purse strings, gotta get some bling bling, get all you can got, but you'll never get the real thing. Wall Street scholars, you running for the dollars. See the noose around your neck that you're wearing as a collar. Push our pictures, boom, set to assume happy we will be by the more we consume. Buyer beware, covet and more. Buyer beware, see greed is the vendor. Money someone made to come and buy my desire. Money someone made to come and dive in the fire. Selling you shit, playing on your fears. But when you scream out, it's upon their fears. Cause the system, the system, the system is not listening. This system that you're insisting to be trusting is not listening. The system, the system, the system is not listening. The system that you're insisting to be trusting is not listening. Everything burns, trust in a liar, no one learns. See, torture is a political tool. Violence is playing by their rules. Bombs and guns made by government sold to terrorists. Bombing innocents to teach governments who are loving it. And you wonder why. Cause war feeds the money machine. The more bombs drop, power coming on green. How can that be living on another's demise? How can someone's death feed our supplies? Cause what's up money made to facilitate harmony? Weren't we made to create and agree? I pick up the phone to call the powers that be. Then I realize no one's listening to me. Cause the system, the system, the system is not listening. This system that you're insisting to be trusting is not listening. This system, the system, the system is not listening. This system that you're insisting to be trusting is not listening. Was it that invented money anyway? Is this what they intended? Well, I think I gotta say, they created a system that we're slaves to. Price is right, we feel that we're made to do anything to increase the profit. What about each other? I think we fucking lost that a long, long time ago. Did we ever know in years to come, will there be anything to show? I'm out of here, I don't need this shit. Then I look around, realize I'm growing in it. I'm like a mushroom of the corporation. One vegetable in a huge plantation. Addicted to technology, so numb, nothing bothers me. Swallow every ad, and I never know what's got to me. I'm infected, I can't detect it. I'm a product that the system perfected. The system, the system, the system is not listening. This system that they're insisting to be trusting is not listening. This system, the system, the system is not listening. This system that you're insisting to be trusting is not listening.
That was Blind Monkey, Deaf System, and G'day to Stu. Awesome stuff, man, and I hope to catch up with you soon, and maybe do some editing. We might need a little bit for this show. Next up, we're going to hear Hail Mary, and then straight after that, Chris Coroner is going to be up with his segment, The Morgue Presents, so hang around for that. But first and last for my segment anyway, is Hail Mary, Yellow Light of Death, and it's off their Navigate the Sunrise EP. These guys are awesome. They're a huge supporter of AMR.FM, as are all the bands. You can catch these guys out at the moment. They're still on tour, I believe. They're Navigate the Sunrise EP tour, so catch them around town. I'm pretty sure they're heading back to Perth very soon, so if you're in Perth, the hometown of the band, you'll be able to catch them live. So here is Yellow Light of Death by Hail Mary, and then it's over to Chris. And I'll catch you later. See you next episode. Well, I'll be back later, won't I? With Chris. All right. Catch ya.
Hi and welcome to the Morgue Metal segment on AMR TV Australia. I'm your host, Chris Coriner, and tonight I've got video clips for you. First off, the band Annihant. They're from Gippsland in Victoria. I have two songs from Metal Asylum 2, which is a Morgue gig. We actually run them and set them up. So if you see any posters or hear about them, come down and check them out. And these two songs called Hemosiris and then Blood on My Suit. Here is Annihant. Hope you enjoy them.
Or a limb. This one's called Hemosiris. This is what happens when you let two nurses write the fucking lyrics. Thank you.
Welcome back to the Morgue Metal segment on AMR TV Australia. That was Annihant with Hemosiris and Blood on My Suit live from Metal Asylum 2. And I'm going to keep the theme of Metal Asylum gigs going at the moment. This next band, they're called Harlot. They're from Melbourne, Victoria, and they're a thrash band. And oh my God, when I have heard them the first time, they blew my mind like I was listening to Slayer or something. They have a album out called Origins, and I definitely suggest that you pick a copy up. They're on tour also with a band called Mason. They're doing the Origins of Hate tour, and that's going around Australia, so check out their Facebook pages for details. And I've got three songs all in the one clip again from Harlot with Origins, In the Black, and Export Life. Enjoy.
Hi, mate. Depends. Are you ready, Bendigo? Has to go that way. The cunt who set this up fucked it. If it goes the other way, it just cuts out.
Hey! you buy it, we will be in the...
Smash his guitar.
Chad Wood. He's such a fucking Chad, that guy. It's like Craig. You know when you meet someone called Craig? You're like, Craig fucking fits you. He's such a fucking Craig.
Smash another head!
Whenever Ryan's ready, we're going to play a song. Dedicated to a very lovely immigrant over there. Who isn't sick of this joke?
I'm not.
I'm sick. It's all right. The song's off our album. It's not called Import Wife.
You can't deny this world is slowly fading, and I'm getting too high.
Welcome back to the Morgue Metal segment. That was Harlot live from Metal Asylum 3. I've got one more song coming up for you tonight from a Sydney band called Before Ciata. It's another live one, again from Metal Asylum 3. And this one's called Ashes of the Damned. Enjoy.
Chriso, awesome segment there, man.
Thank you. Love my heavy metal and hope everybody out there enjoyed it as well.
Yep, and we're going to have you back next week, or, well, pretty close to a week, I think.
Yep.
It shouldn't take us long to get another episode up, I think.
Nah, it should be good. Once this one's done, it'll all be flowing and we'll build it up and keep growing.
Yep, we'll shake the cobwebs and get it happening. Yep, absolutely. Now, we heard some pretty cool music tonight. What's on stall next time?
What's
any ideas?
Next week? Not a clue yet. Let me work on it. I'm thinking it's going to be Trigger and Orpheus Amiga, probably.
Okay, and I might have.
Oh, geez. It's a tough question, isn't it?
Might have a bit of Crash and Burn. There's so many to choose from at the moment. The Sign. Who else have we got?
Calzine.
Yeah, might chuck a live one of them in. Yeah, you've got one of those, haven't you?
Yep.
Plenty coming up.
Stay tuned.
Watch out on our pages, Australian Musicians Radio and
The Morgue Radio.
Yep, and as many of you would already know, you can catch me on my radio show on Tuesday nights, the Southern Cross Connection, and you can catch Chris.
I don't do radio shows at the moment.
Doesn't do radio shows at the moment. But you can catch the Morgue radio.
I just own and run it, and yeah, I'm not doing shows at the moment. But there are people on the station who do shows, so like our Facebook page, The Morgue Radio, for updates.
Yep, and how do they tune into The Morgue?
Just go to the Facebook, then you'll find all the addresses.
There's the links.
There's links to open the radio server and the website.
Alrighty, so there you go. And that's our first episode, man.
Yep.
Alrighty. Hang on to this for a sec.
Why?
Wrong pocket. Hang on. Alrighty. God.
Yay!
Alright, we'll catch you next episode.
See you later.